The brains of the operation has finally stepped onto the battlefield, everyone. It is time for everyone to see what Alvin is all about. And we're going to see his intelligence at work. Oh! Okay, Alvin's not impressed. I get it.
So seriously, you guys are spying for Azure, right?
What? Of course not.
I've never heard of the Military Powers Act being used against anyone other than Azure spies.
You're thinking too much into this.
Why are you so concerned about this? Unless you're spying for Rashigal.
No. I was just thinking that if you were spying for Azul, maybe you could use your connections to score me some high-paying intelligence work.
Sorry to disappoint you, but I assure you I will pay your fee. You just have to wait a little bit longer.
Fair enough. But even with your special friend discount, the interest is piling up.
That special friend discount, wow. Creeping suspicion. Man, don't have creeping suspicions.
Is Milla really that Maxwell? She does act a bit nutty, but she looks normal enough.
I think it's true. When I first met her, Milla had the four great spirits with her.
What? Get out of here.
No, seriously. Fire spirit Efreet, water spirit Undine, wind spirit Sylph, and earth spirit Gnome. It was the first time I'd ever seen them in person, but there was no mistaking who they were.
That's a mighty exclusive club. Can't imagine they hang out with a lot of mortal girls.
Yeah.
Most definitely not. That person has another quest? What the heck? Let's grab her quest first. More monsters have taken up residence at the lake west of Sea Haven. As a local mercenary to take them care of them, but I'm afraid the monsters got to her. Could you go to the lake and rescue her, please? Thank you yet again. I don't know if it's necessarily important to do that, but... Excuse me, doesn't mean we can't accept it anyway. The head chef said I need to learn how to make soda rice. Unfortunately, I don't have the first clue how to go about it. Could you help me? Thank you. If I can eat just once, I should be able to figure out how to make it. Soda rice? I mean, I could just buy it at the shop, right? Oh, by the way, I realize there's actually no spoilers in here at all. I just have Jude costumes, Alvin costumes, Milla costumes. This would probably have spoilers in it, if anything. But, yeah, I honestly don't need to worry about it, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. But yes, Alvin has the Kratos outfit. He has the outfit, everyone. It's just, you know, it is what it is. Oh gosh, no, that's spoilers. Okay, probably should not use that, but I'm gonna do it anyway. And 1,000 gold, heck with it. Does it matter? No, nothing matters anymore. Nothing matters anymore. But look at all this stuff. This stuff is crazy, man. Look at how he changes. Look at that hair. Look at that hair, man. That is crazy. And then, oh, it's beautiful. It's freaking beautiful, man. Oh gosh, the green just looks so weird, honestly. But that is freaking beautiful, man. So here's the other hair. Here's the other styles for Jude. Like, honestly, it doesn't look that different from... Like, it's like, it gets more in his eyes. That's really the only difference, I feel. And then he has Kress hair as well, and then... There's the Leon outfit. We'll put him with the hair, too. See, it fits him. It just fits him, man. It fits him a little too well, honestly. Meanwhile, it's like, why would you ever use this? That doesn't fit at all. And then same with that, and then... Just for literally no reason. Like, hey, a Yuri Lowell. That's kind of cool, right? I want to edit the attachment. I wonder why it doesn't come with hair. I think it'd be like, hey, let's give some hair here. Okay, this is the thing that always got me, and I don't understand this at all. Can anybody tell the difference? Like, literally anybody. I admit, I see a very, 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 very subtle difference. You notice, like, beneath... Oh, how do I point this out, honestly? You guys notice, like, right beneath that long hair on top of her head? How there's, like, one kind of hair sticking out right there? Right below that? You go to that, it's gone, and then it's back, and then it's gone, and then it's back, and then it's gone, and then it's back. That is the only thing I can notice with that, but other than that, they look exactly the same. Or, like, very freaking close to the same. I don't even know, man. But yeah, there's her with the Stawn outfit and the Stawn hair. Not that you can tell the difference, but I mean, eh. There's her alternate outfit, which is very blue. I did not remember it being blue, honestly. And then the Azbel outfit, because yes, no Azbel hair, though. I don't quite understand why she gets the Azbel costume, but I mean, you know, it is what it is. Anyway, it's cool. It's pretty cool. I do often debate if I should even use these costumes in the first place. This is not a blind playthrough, so I mean, it's like... I wouldn't really lose anything by... Oh, they have the earrings and the longsword, too. Just give them the blast, yeah, because yes. Anyway, I don't know. It's always a debate. Like, should I do it? Should I do it? I mean, it is not a blind playthrough. If I was playing this first time, absolutely, for sure. Why do that, you know? Use their original costumes. That's what I always feel. I feel like you should use the original costumes in the first playthrough. But if you're doing it... a not first playthrough, then, you know, I don't know, go wild with it. Just make a mess out of things. I mean, does anyone remember Inside and Out?
Oops, gotta straighten my scarf.
You sure do love that thing.
Don't you? It's one of Fismaj's finest, custom made for yours truly.
I don't know much about brands, but it does look good on you.
You gotta be careful about what you wear, kid. It's how the world judges a man.
I'd rather think what's inside is what counts.
Yeah, and this is how what's inside gets projected to the outside.
You don't believe some people shape what's outside in order to conceal the ugliness within?
Well, if you can't see through a false front, isn't that your problem?
So you blame the victims for being deceived?
If that's really what you believe, Alvin, it tells me all I need to know about what's within.
Man, I sure slipped up this time, huh?
Oops. Sometimes you just slip up, you know? Can't help it. You cannot help it indeed. But that's okay. I also forgot to go get the thing at the inn. I got distracted and forgot, and there's another quest over there. Oops. Fruit merchant. Anything about oranges? I heard they grow around here. Find a nice one, I'd like to buy it from you. Sure. So bring me a porridge, wonderful. A porridge, yummy. Bring me a porridge, I'll give you a good price for it. Okay, I guess I have no porridges. The frick is a porridge? Is that a real thing? Okay, I believe this guy wants soda rice, right? 25 expansion points, we added the food vendor. Oh yeah, let's go. Gotta add them food vendor points, am I right? Alright, I believe you were the one who wanted the soda rice, correct? Correct, Mundo? Which dish will you give? Soda rice small. Yes, please. Also, this is soda rice. Oh, I see, they use miso as a secret ingredient to balance soda and rice flavors. Thanks, now I'll be able to grow and improve as a chef. Bushy eyebrows and 1200 gall. We got a profit. Let's go. Alright, well, now that we did that, now we can officially get out of here. So we'll want to go to the right. I mean, unless we want to do that side quest. I mean, is there any reason we would want to do the side quest? I guess that's one thing I would wonder. Do we want to do that? I mean, I think some side quests would be nice to do, but I don't know if... I don't remember how important some of the side quests even really were in the first place. Like, do we want to be going out of our way to do some of these? I don't feel like that's the case, but I don't know. Beautiful feathers times three, the four.
Walking sure is grueling.
That's unexpected coming from you.
I'm just used to having Soph fly me everywhere. The only time I ever really walked was when I used Undine to travel across water.
I see.
Maybe this is your punishment for treating the four great spirits like your personal servants?
Servants? They may help out now and then, but they're the ones who pester me. They're like a bunch of bickering in-laws that never go home.
Did you just call the four bickering in-laws?
Man, imagine having four great spirits and just being like, I'm gonna be a bickering in-law now, let's go. Hamil, the Eastern District. Well, definitely going the right way. Anyway, you guys want to see some Alvin action in action? Pair up with Jude, because why not? All right, okay. Oh, geez, look at him about to take that swing. He's like, I'm gonna get you, man. Oh, we're gonna spam some Demon Fang for days. Demon Fang.
Let's do this.
Oh yeah. Is Tiger Blade chainable too? I feel like I remember there being a lot of stuff you could chain with Jude when you're using Alvin, if I remember correctly. Alvin's charge ability. If you continue to hold circle after Alvin forms an art, he will enter charge state. While in charge state, Alvin's gun and sword fuse together to make all of his arts more powerful.
Excellent.
Oh yeah, I gotta try that out a little bit, don't I? Alright, Milla. If that is your real name. We'll just go ahead and do that. Add them 5 TP. Wind God. Increases resistance to wind by 30%. Is it necessary for setting skills? Ooh. Affects movement speed strongly and physical attack and physical defense slightly. That seems like that'd be a good one to go down on, honestly. I don't see why not. And we can just go this way and be like, oh my gosh, let's go. We got this now. Wait. Did I finish? Oh, I did finish. Okay, I wasn't sure if I finished for some weird reason. I don't know why. I just didn't think I finished at all. More beautiful feathers. We have so many beautiful feathers. We don't even know what to do with them all.
Don't get killed.
Don't get killed. True, just don't get killed, you know. Oh, man. I'm kind of glad that newer Tales games at least let the cameo costumes be, like, free. Usually pre-order DLC.
Yeah.
Ouch, the cold shoulder.
Oh no, not the cold shoulders. But these first couple PS3 games, Graces, Xillia, did Symphony do that too? I don't remember. I don't remember if Symphony Chronicles did that or not. I think Xillia 2 did it as well. But like the first few Tales games that were on PS3, they basically had like, oh, you gotta buy the costume DLC if you want the cameo costumes. The only ones, yeah, and obviously the only ones I bought were freaking Kratos, and honestly, I want to say that the Kress and Ston ones were a pre-order bonus, because I sure as heck don't remember ever buying those. I don't know why I would buy those, but that's kind of my theory in that it's most likely long step. From front steps and back steps over a greater distance. Ooh. Yeah, I think that's the most likely scenario that happened there, though, is I probably bought... If I had to guess, I probably bought the Kratos one, obviously. I think I bought the Leon outfit. I'm I'm trying to figure out why I got the Yuri costume. Was that literally just because we didn't have Tales of Vesperia on PS3 or something? Is that why we got the Yuri costume? And then the Kress outfit, I have no idea what that was all about. I don't remember that either. I don't think I bought the Stawn outfit. Maybe I bought the Asbel outfit. I really don't know, honestly. Partners in Climb?
Compared to Fenmont's Night Climb, the sky in Azul sure is bright.
That's true. The spirit climbs here are much more stable.
What are you talking about? What do you intend to climb?
C-L-I-M-E. Surely the great Lady Maxwell knows all about the subject?
Don't flatter yourself by assuming I recognize every arbitrary word you humans create. Human arrogance can be so trying.
Milla, do you know what Rieze Maxia is made of?
As if I wouldn't know? The power of spirits composes the entire natural world.
I knew it.
The term spirit climb refers to the balance of spirit power. When that power is out of balance, nature can become polarized in one direction. That's why there are unusual spirit climbs, like the perpetual night of Fenmont.
I see. Thank you. Now I understand. You're very good at explaining things.
My pleasure.
Oh, I see how it is. I guess I'm just an arrogant human compared to little old innocent Jude.
Oh man, little old innocent Jude. Oh my gosh. Hey you, would you like to die, monsters? Oh gosh, I'm pushing Jude, why? Gotta keep in shape, man.
Time to go to work.
Oh jeez. Oh jeez, man. Die. Get Demon Fang, man! Give us the power of the linking. All the linking. If you don't link, you're gonna not be very good at what you're doing today. Oh, jeez. They're called goblins. Oh, man, imagine goblins. Why the frick did you use an item? Was that just because I lost too much TP? Oh my gosh, I can't get the next freaking thing here. I'm trying, but it's just not working, man. It's just not working. 400 gold. Oh, hello there, random enemy. Tried to ambush me from behind. I can't believe you would do that. Okay, so saving that game. Oh yes, indeed. Let's freaking go. We're gonna go all the way to the next save file, and then we're gonna go to Hamil. And then we're gonna be like, oh, hello there. This is the Eastern District. Nice. Can we go to the Western District, please? Directions. Yummy.
Wow, that's an impressive amount of fruit.
I'm catching a whiff of cider. Oh, they must have orchards here.
Well, well, well. We don't get many visitors here.
Do you live here, ma'am?
I would hope so. I'm the mayor.
Is this the right road to Nia Khera?
Nia Khera? Now that's a name I haven't heard in ages.
What do you mean?
It's what people called a long-forgotten village. I don't even know if it still exists. I heard tales of the village as a child. People claimed it lies beyond the Kijara Sea Falls.
Where can we find it?
You'll need to cross some seriously rugged terrain to get there. It won't be an easy journey.
In that case, we should probably rest here before heading on.
Agreed.
I'm afraid our little village doesn't have an inn. Not much call for one. But I've an extra room in my house. You're welcome to use it if you like.
Thank you for your hospitality, ma'am.
You're absolutely welcome indeed. Alright, the perfect catalyst. Man, I love catalysts. They're so cool.
So, why bother taking human form at all?
Spirits are really just masses of mana. They can't interact with the temporal world in that state. For a spirit to take physical form, it needs a catalyst of a corresponding element. As an example, the fire spirit of Freet can take form as a blazing inferno.
And as Maxwell, you can be any element, right?
The human body contains all four elements, so it's the perfect catalyst for me to take a physical form.
What would happen if you lost your catalyst?
I would gather elements to make a new one, but I'd have to wait for it to grow up.
Grow up? You mean you start as a baby?
It's time-consuming, but if you want to use a human form as a catalyst, you have to wait for the body to develop.
So even the Lord of Spirits isn't omnipotent?
Not in this human realm, anyway.
Let's just be grateful she didn't go with the male model, eh?
Wouldn't bother me.
Oh, you swing both ways?
That's not what I meant.
Yeah, good job, Alvin. Good job. Oh man, this game sometimes. It is just great. It is great. It's got that sense of humor to it. It's nice. I don't want to sell stuff. You can't make me sell anything. I don't know why I'm even looking at this. Honestly, like, I'm not getting anything until I... Wait. Hold on. Now I think about it, what's stopping me from just buying a bunch of these and being like, I'm just gonna go crazy now. Let me just buy a bunch of these. maybe don't max out on all of these. Let's go with like 13 of each. 337, nice. Shop level 3, very nice. What are those discounts? Those are nice discounts there. Excuse me, oh gosh. Suddenly casually dying once again, oh boy. Searching the village, what are we searching for though? What do they want us to find here? Do they want us to find something here? The Fruit of Temptation? I want the Fruit of Temptation.
Apple fruits! No wonder it smells so good around here. Wow, look how juicy they are.
Mmm, is that so?
They look like they're at the peak of ripeness. Sweet with just a hint of tartness.
That sounds... interesting.
Mila, you're drooling really bad.
For some reason, I can't make it stop.
Sounds like your body has awakened to the joys of eating.
Just keep those mitts off the merchandise. Our rap sheet's long enough as it is.
Honestly, kind of forgot about the... I don't know. I kind of forgot this game did the full body portraits in the skits, though, honestly. But then again, this isn't the first game that did that, too. I think, yeah, Vesperi did that. One called what? Interesting. Vesperi. You know what? And now I think about Abyss did it, too. Symphonia, I think, was the one that didn't do it. So, yeah, actually, now that I think about this, that goes back a lot further than I realized it did. At some point, I really should just, go crazy with some more of those, but I'm not gonna do it right now. We do it later. We do it later, and that's final. Is this a place where we can get some stuff? The mayor's house? Hello, mayor? We are at the mayor's house. The mayor is mayoring. Wow, what a house. Great house, mayor. Great house. You have the most house of all houses that I've ever housed. Whoa, okay. That's why you don't buy all the life bottles you can buy. If you buy them all, you're just gonna waste space. We just, bro. There's a save point in their house too. So we just stole a life bottle and 300 gold from the mayor's house. We're gonna have to answer for these crimes. We are definitely going to have to answer for these crimes. No doubt about it. Okay, Echo, what the frick? Is this game breaking the fourth wall? I was talking about an Echo, I think, what, last episode, wasn't I? Oh boy, I swear.
What a beautiful view. I bet if I yelled really loud, it would echo back.
So why not try it? You gotta do things like that while you're still young. When you get to be my age, it can get a little embarrassing.
Yeah, all right, why not? Echo!
Echo, 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 echo.
Alvin?
Alvin, Alvin.
Gosh dang it.
And what you're doing now isn't embarrassing?
A little, a little, a little, a little.
A little, a little. I tried turning the volume up on my TV before that happened, but I don't know if that was properly caught.
Nothing. Get lost.
Wrong answer, Squirt. Now we really want to know what you're looking at.
It's some sort of shiny object.
It's my shiny object.
I love shiny objects.
Looks like a puzzle. A difficult one at that.
How about this?
Whoa, what's happening?
This looks like our letters, but different. More like ancient writing.
Let's see here. Heed my words, for I am Ifrid, the intrepid explorer who has crossed the world's edge without fear. Yada yada yada, more self-promotion. Ah, here we go. At last, I have reached Terra Incognita. But alas, I am unable to return home. I shall take my many treasures, seal them in arks, and scatter them about this land. It is my hope that they shall serve as beacons to those explorers who follow in my footsteps.
I'm impressed, Alvin.
But I still don't know what it means.
I've heard of this Ifrid. He's a legendary pirate. He raided cities all throughout Rieze Maxia ages ago. He set off to find the end of the world and never returned. Or so the legend goes.
Nice of him to put his treasures in these boxes for us.
The pirate Ifrid's treasures? Oh, I want to find him too!
Maybe you should learn to read first, young man.
Yeah, good idea. You'll all wait for me, right? And keep this Ifrid treasure stuff between us.
As you travel about the various dungeons and fields along your journey, you may come across special treasure chests that contain strange and mysterious items. These are known as Ifrid's treasures. Be sure to seek them out. Honestly, I don't remember what those do at all. But we'll definitely. We'll do our best to try and get as many as we can anyway. I don't remember all the details on this stuff, what makes it important, but yeah, we'll figure it out. Anyway, to the west we go. Oh yes, rest of the merit. Wait, oh. Well, I didn't realize we were going to the mayor's house now. Now we want to be here. The freaking mayor. Who's ready? Would you like to turn in for the night? Yes. Also, please return the 300 gold you stole from me, you nincompoops. Oh, we're old.
Mike, what are you up to?
Watching people.
Okay. Say, Milla, can I ask you something? What's a Spyrix? Why were you trying to destroy that device in Fenmont?
Spyrix technology is something humans were never meant to have. So I must take it away from them.
Why?
That is none of your concern.
You're not allowed to know.
So you don't trust me.
That's not it. Look, if you saw a toddler playing with a knife, what would you do?
I'd probably snatch it away.
And what would be your reason?
Because it's dangerous. The baby doesn't know how to use a knife. He could cut himself. Or worse.
There's your answer.
What? But we're not babies. If we understand what we're dealing with, and if we see the dangers, we can learn how to use it safely.
So you say. But to me, you're no different than infants. I will do what I must to protect this world. If that means destroying the Lance of Kresnik, so be it. It's my mission.
I see.
Don't worry, Jude. None of this will concern you once we reach Nia Khera.
No, they said. No.
What's going on?
No.
Oh.
It would seem we can't linger around here anymore.
So they did follow us.
No, kid. They found us awfully fast considering this isn't their home turf.
Well, it's not like we can ask them about it. Let's go before they find us.
Hey, how'd you find us so fast?
That must be the way to the Kajara Sea Falls.
Alright, let's go. Let's get out of here. Just kidding, let's not get out of here. Let's go talk to these guys. Getting close to the guards might spot us. How would they not already spot us from there? I mean, like, we were so close to them. Like, right next to them. It's crazy, man. It's crazy. Look at those horses. Oh, they're so majestic. See, they're so majestic.
The soldiers beat us here.
Great. Now what?
Brute force.
Our way through.
Right, and fast, before any more arrive.
So that's your plan? Just charge through? I thought I was hot-headed.
Excuse me.
What is it?
What are you doing?
We're trying to figure out how to get past.
Wait, the
those
doll
soldiers.
Wasn't even moving in her arms.
Way to cut to the chase.
The doll is not moving.
So those people, they're in your way.
Like she's moving, but it's not moving.
Hey, what? Ah!
What in the world? How did you do that?
What's going on here, child? You know you're never to leave the shed. Rashagal troops,
how
curse
dare
you
leave
how
the
dare
shed?
You come here.
Huh? Where's she going?
Which way did she go?
Toward the square.
What? No, she mustn't. You all must be outsiders. You should hurry and leave this place.
I have no idea what just happened, but I ain't complaining. Things just got easier for us.
Let's get out of here.
What if we don't want to, though? Head to Nia Khera to the Kajara Sea Falls. I mean, I could just go over here and be like, hey, I don't know. Where'd she go? Was it over here? I have no idea what I'm doing anymore. I am just getting 5 gold for us now. Let's go.
Hey, the porridge berries are ripe. You can make a nice liqueur out of these.
Is this where you get the porridges? Well, time to find out. I guess we'll go up the trees. I wasn't planning to go up this ladder, but once he said porringes, I'm like, well, man, we can finish that one side quest now. If there are actually porringes.
Don't go looking up when a lady's climbing above you.
I'm not you, Alvin.
Oh gosh, Alvin, what are you thinking, man? How could you do this, man? How could you do this? Dude, I don't see anything up here. I see nothing sparkling, so what's the point?
I felt totally weightless.
Yeah, I kind of want to do that again.
All right, you want to do it again, Jude? Let's do it again. Let's do it again. Just because you wanted to. Here we go. We're gonna go and do it again. Whee! Nice. Good jump there. Good jump there. Anyway. I think... What is this? 500 gold. That's crazy, man. There is absolutely nothing in there. Oh, no. I can't steal any gold from here. That's unfortunate. Man, if only we could steal gold from everywhere. Everywhere would be a much better place without their gold, right? Right. Excuse me. Anyway, excuse me. I'm just burping, I'm just coughing, don't mind me, I'm just going crazy at this point. But anyway, everyone, I think that's it for today. On the next exciting episode, we'll go ahead and hit up, well, I guess the Galia Trail, because, I mean, I guess that's going to be how we're going to get to the Kajara Sea Falls. That's the only one that makes sense to me. But anyway, everyone, let me know what you think of this village. Let me know what you think of the Rashagal army finding us so quickly. How did they find us so quickly? And what is up with the animations, man? Like, that doll that girl was holding. Like, what the heck, man? Why was it not moving? Like, she was moving, but the doll was not moving. Something is not right. Something is defying physics. And, well... I don't know. Physics. Whoa. Hello, everyone. You've reached the end of this video. But before we go for the day, I'd just like to give a quick shout out to our Tier 4, 5, and 6 channel members. Phoenix Edgeworth, Akron X2, Jello Cat, and Savage. Thank you guys for being awesome and supporting the channel. If you too would like to get your name shouted out at the end of each video and live stream, shoutouts are available to all Tier 4, 5, and 6 channel members. I hope you have an awesome day, and I'll see you next time!